Welcome to Music Diary Group, the hottest podcast for inspirational and gospel entertainment, featuring undiscovered artists from across the globe, unlocking the music from hip-hop to rock. We got it.
Welcome to Music Diary Group, the hottest podcast for inspirational and gospel entertainment. I'm your host, Sincere on Beats.
And I'm your girl, Daycee, D-A-Y-C-E-E, in the place to be.
What up, Daycee?
What up, Sincere?
I'm chilling. Thank you for tuning in again.
Yay, welcome back.
Yes. Today's show is titled Synesthesia. Synesthesia.
What? Well, I guess we're going to find out what that is.
Yeah, you're going to find out in a minute. But first, we got to go to the sponsor.
So our first sponsor for this show is beautypar.com, your online boutique.
Yeah.
So ladies, get your shop on.
Get your shop on.
In the comfort of your own home.
Yes, nobody got to know what you're buying.
Right, at beautypar.com.
Yeah, I'm not going to tell you what it is.
It's a lot of stuff from wherever you can get from a boutique, you can get from Beauty Par.
Boom. So now we're going to go to the song of the week.
Who is the artist of the week?
My man's in them. Oh. Nehemiah Jones. Ooh. From Brooklyn, New York.
I like Nehemiah Jones.
Word. Okay. I like him too. So check it out.
Unlocking the music.
Thank God for the grace and for the gift of life. For the money, for the fame, and for the peace of mind. Now I am unstoppable, now I am unstoppable. They cannot run me down, they cannot run me down. All over. We get the money now, all over. They put up for it now, all over. We get the money now, all over. God bless is coming, knocking all over.
We get the mama money. People used to hate me, now they love me. Used to be dumb and you know it's sunny. Flexi rap by my side, that's my buddy. Blessings is coming, it's crazy. Wasting no money on jewelry. Haters can set up and ride me. Happens too much all the time, man. We gon' get it, we gon' split it, tell you the truth, cause we brothers. He's on a mission and I'm on a mission, so God put us together, plugged us. Nothing around us above us, only the presence of Jesus. Praise it that we had to get all this money so the people could come and believe us.
Yeah, thank God for the grace and for the gift of life. For the money, for the fame, and for the peace of mind. Now I am unstoppable, now I am unstoppable. They cannot run me down, they cannot run me down.
Yeah, that's my boy Nehemiah Jones. He's very versatile in his music, man. I really like that cat.
So he got some of that. He got some rap. He got a lot of things going on that album.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Shouts out to you, Nehemiah. All right. You know what I'm saying? So stay tuned for more of Nehemiah. But if you want to send your songs or any music video to us, go ahead and send it to musicdiarygroup@gmail.com. That's musicdiarygroup@gmail. Please, no links, MP3 and MP form format is welcome.
Yeah, we're looking forward to hearing some of that new underground music.
Yeah, yo, I'm telling you, man, I love the underdogs, especially if you hot. Yeah. So, you know, I ride with you cats all day.
And all genres, too.
Yeah, all genres. All genres. Yeah, but you know, we into hip-hop is our culture, so that's why you hear a lot of hip-hop on our podcast right now. But we love all genres of music.
Yeah, absolutely.
So, yeah, let's get into synesthesia.
Right. So, I think we ended off with what is synesthesia. You know, we like to do on the Music Diary Group podcast. We like to...
Yeah, because we are a music podcast, so synesthesia has to do with music.
Right, and we like to look it up.
We got to look it up, man. Yeah, so we got to see what it is.
Educate ourselves.
So can you do me a favor? Can you look it up?
Already did.
Boom, here we go.
All right, so synesthesia is a neurological condition in which stimulation of one sensory or cognitive pathway, for example, hearing, leads to automatic involuntary experiences in a second sensory or cognitive pathway, such as vision. Simply put, when one sense is activated, another unrelated sense is activated at the same time. This may, for instance, take the form of hearing music and simultaneously sensing the sound as swirls or patterns of color.
Oh.
It's interesting, right? And I guess my question to you is, when you came up and said, hey, let's do this topic, is what does it have to do with the music? Like, what, I know you talked about artists having it.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Well, let me tell you. Let me explain. So with synesthesia, Mary J. Blige has it. Kanye West. We always talking about Kanye West on the show for some reason. Mm-hmm. He's not even sponsoring us. But he just do so much. Yeah. I don't know.
Just getting free sponsorship.
Yeah, he's just everywhere. But and Pharrell Williams has all we and I have synesthesia.
So they all came forward and said they had it.
They said they have it. You know, yeah. How some have it is a key. They might hear a certain key and they'll know if it's the right key or not because they see a color. So they associate a color with a specific key.
Okay. How do you think that like affects their ability to make music? Do you think it makes it better, makes it more accurate?
I think it makes it better and accurate because if somebody can see sound, see color and see sound, that's just spectacular. You're like, oh my God, like what can I do with this? Like, it's just amazing.
So I'm thinking, you know, I'm thinking of like an orchestra leader and how amazing that would be if they had that type of synesthesia where they can like see colors with the different sounds. Like I can't even imagine what they're seeing then if they're conducting an orchestra and you're like green, yellow, pink, purple, you know, with the different instruments.
You know what's amazing? When I hear like an orchestra, for some reason I associate that specific music with like red and yellow. I see red and yellow.
Okay.
You know, I see that type of music, red and yellow.
Yeah, I could see how that would make that sensation, that sense or synesthesia, that condition.
Yeah.
Would maybe give you some kind of musical superpower.
I don't think it's a superpower, you know, but it's just a feeling like how I... Can I say this now or can I talk about this later?
Wait. I know I don't want you to ruin the end.
Yeah. I can see, you know.
But I kind of feel like, and what I mean by superpower is just that you have some, you can maybe be more accurate, more accurate than other people with certain, you know, processes.
Yeah, you can process it
a little bit different.
Music, yeah. You can process music a little different. You usually can make, I don't want to say better music because, you know, it's a talent that God gives people, music ability. So I want to say you're creative because you're seeing, you know, like how you're looking at me. That's how I see music. It's so clear. When I hear a certain key.
Okay.
Or something, I hear certain music, I see that.
Okay.
You know,
Now you on point.
I'm on point. Yo.
Don't make me.
Daisy keeps me in check because I just go everywhere, you know what I mean? So I got to make sure I'm staying on topic, you know, and on point. You know, we can't just be out here just...
Everywhere.
You know, everywhere, you know, like some podcasts. You know, we got to be organized.
Dig.
Yeah, so...
So... You were saying that it's underreported.
Yeah, it's underreported.
What's the percentage of people that actually report that they have it?
They say it's like 4% of people who actually have this, but I think it's higher than that.
Okay.
Matter of fact, I know it's higher than that.
So why do you think it's underreported?
For quite a few reasons. Number one, you may not want to talk about it, or you can assume everybody has it. Like,
okay,
so like I assume.
Yeah, what was your experience?
This happened some years ago. I want to say 2012. I was in the studio with my business partner. Shouts out to you, Joseph Williams. He's like the best bass player in the game. But we was tracking a record for either, I want to say Kendra Chantel or Paul Porter. I can't remember. And it was just so beautiful. I was like, man. I said, yo, it's amazing how we can see color when we hear in music. He looked at me like I was crazy. You know, like the face he gave me, he like stopped dead in his track, was like...
More than usual? Because a lot of people look at you.
More than usual. Yeah, it was like... like, yo, you for real? You know what I mean? And I'm like, yo, I'm serious. Like, you don't see color when you hear music? He was like, no. So he actually said he was going to look it up. But we never got a chance to look it up. I mean, it just... went out of our heads, you know, what life happens and whatever. We just never looked it up. But it wasn't until a year ago where I actually looked it up again, mm-hmm. right? And figured out that it had a name, synesthesia, because of a company called Syngang, right? Synesthetic Nation.com. Those guys actually send us music when we had artists and we was like lit in the game. And their logo was like a different colors. So and then their music had tags on it. And I couldn't understand like what was synesthetic. So I decided to look up synesthetic, and it was what Daisy just read. It was mm-hmm. that. And I said, listen, this is what I have. And you know, yeah. that's what we found out. That's what it was. Synesthesia.
Yeah, he told me he sees. I see colors when I hear these notes. When I hear this song, I see red and black. And I'm like, yo, okay, say so. Yeah, I just tucked it away. You know, that's kind of what I do when somebody says something oddball. Yeah, you know what I mean? Yeah. I'm like, I don't say yay or nay. I'm just like, if you say so, that's your reality.
That's messed up, man. that's messed up, man.
But, you know, he proved to me with this word, and just look this up. And I said, oh, it's a real thing.
Yeah.
Okay. As a matter of fact, there's several different types.
Yeah, they are.
Let me read the types real quick. Yeah, because we looked up. This whole article actually on Psychology Today. It'll be in the link, right?
I'll put everything mm-hmm. in the link.
And so, yeah, we'll put this up. But there's since synesthesia can involve any combination of the senses, there may be as many as 60 to 80 subtypes. However, not all types of synesthesia have been documented or studied, and the cause remains unclear. So some of the types include auditory tactile synesthesia, which occurs when a sound prompts a specific bodily sensation, such as a tingling on the back of one's neck. Then there's chromesthesia, which occurs when certain sounds like a car honking can trigger someone to see colors.
Perfect example, real quick. Mm-hmm. I want to say, was it last week or the week before that?
A couple of weeks ago.
Somebody had a almost like a train horn. And I was like, yo, that's so beautiful. She was like, what the freak you talking about now? I'm like, yo, that horn, it was yellow to me. So when I heard that, it was yellow. And I was like, oh, that's awesome. Mm-hmm. She was like, yo, whatever, B.
Yeah, usually. That's usually my response when he says something. okay. Tucking it away.
It's jacked up again.
But like I said, I was surprised that it's actually a thing. Yeah, like, yeah. You know, a lot of people, and that's the issue, right? A lot of people don't know.
Yeah, a lot of people don't know.
So then there's a grapheme color synesthesia, which occurs when letters and numbers are associated with specific colors. There's a few more. I'm just going to read one more.
Okay.
The ordinal linguistic personification is a kind of synesthesia when ordered sequences, such as the days of the week, are associated with personalities or genders.
So, another one that I have. I have three.
That you know of.
That I know of. Mm-hmm. Another one is, I associate the days of the week with colors. For instance, which was just talking about this. It's so freaking funny. You know, our podcast comes out on Tuesdays, right? What am I wearing? I'm wearing blue. I associate Tuesdays with blue. I mean, I could go on with the days of the week. Like every day, different days of the week remind me of, I see certain colors, but Tuesdays is blue to me. Mm-hmm. You know, and I have also feeling when I hear a certain type of instruments and different notes put together, it's a feeling that I get. I kind of look special. I don't want to say, like, you know, we ain't going to say the other word, but I feel special. Like, I look kind of weird, you know what I mean? Because I feel this emotion comes over me.
Where you feel it at? In your back?
Yeah, I feel it. Yeah.
In the back of your neck?
Yeah. You say, I feel it. And I'm like, I can't express the feeling, man, but I get that feeling too. So I have three that I know about.
Mm-hmm. So you said it's underreported because you thought it felt like it was normal.
Yeah, I thought it was normal. You know mm-hmm. what I mean? But after my man looked at me crazy, I stopped talking about it because I felt like I was crazy a little bit. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean?
And you sound a little crazy. Yeah, to sound be
a little crazy. Yeah, you don't want nobody mm-hmm. to telling you you're crazy because something that you know you see. You know what I mean? But I tell you this, yo, embrace that thing. You know, put it in the comments and you're not alone, man. It's a great thing because I feel like I'm on LSD, you know what I'm saying?
So it's more like a blessing?
Yeah, I think it's more mm-hmm. like it's a blessing, man. You know what I mean? And be aware of it. You know, because it's amazing.
All right.
So. You can't die from it. You know what I'm saying? It's not one of those conditions if you can die from it. It's not that.
It still kind of sounds like a superpower to me. Super, like you got a special superpower.
Yeah, it's awesome, man. You know?
So if you happen to have it, if this is like something that just kind of turned on the light for you and say, hey, that's me, I think I have that, put it in the comments. I know there's some that feel like everybody has some form of synesthesia. That's that out there too, as kind of a theory that it's just, you know, some people experience it more than others. Mm-hmm. They're still kind of being studied, and people are just now coming forward and saying, "Hey, I have this."
I don't understand how they could do, you know, like how they can determine who has it or not. I mean,
only by probably report. People have to come forward and say, "Hey, yeah, you know."
But there's some liars out there too. You know what I mean? Yeah,
they have a special test that they've come up with.
I'm not even sure if that's accurate, you know, but mm-hmm. I think like consistency, mm-hmm. like one of the things is consistency on how to do it.
That was part of the test too. Testing the consistency of it to see if it's something that is an actual condition.
Okay. Okay.
So it's still, like I said, it's still being studied, you know, things, you know,
cool.
Things are always being studied. So it's very interesting.
Yes. Yes.
Know? And so, yeah, if you have it, you know, put it in the comments and which type, you know, what kind do you have? Like, how does it manifest?
And embrace that thing, yo.
Yeah, it's very interesting.
So, listen, mm-hmm. I'm gonna play a little beat from Sin Gang, you know what I mean, on our way out. So, check this out. Let me know what you think, man. And shout out to Sin Gang again. Yo, that was Sin Gang. So if you need some music, go to synestheticnations.com. Like I said, man, we've been rocking with them for some years now. When we used to be active in the industry and all that. So
right.
They also were, hold on. Let me say this.
Ahead, yeah.
You know what I mean? They work for They work with artists from like Dragon, OG Genesis, OT Genesis, Designer, and Plyce. So yeah, there's some big names.
Yeah, so they've been out there.
They've been out there.
Okay, yeah, yeah. And then, like I said, we're like, "What is it?" One day, right? We was like, "What is synesthetics?"
Yeah,
and that's what made us look it up.
Yeah.
So thank you.
Yeah,
you educated us
exactly. So go to synestheticnations.com.
All right, and that actually concludes our show. Right?
Yeah, we're done.
We're going to the who's our other sponsor?
Or dangerous. Or dangerous means ordained by God, dangerous to the devil. Go out and purchase one of their shirts, their summer gear.
Yeah, or dangerous.com.
Or dangerous.com. There's ordaingerous.
Or dangerous.
Or dangerous.
All right.
So that concludes this show.
Yes.
Thank you for tuning in. Remember, subscribe and like this video.
Yes, and thank you to our subscribers.
Yeah, thank you for everything that you do for us, because you know, you helping us get on the map, and I appreciate that, and I know DC appreciate that as well.
Absolutely.
So if nobody told you that they love you, remember, we do.
Unlocking the music.
Rap I kick will make you think I'm a lunatic. Lost my mind or mentally sick. Uh-huh. But for all mankind, this is it. New kingdom on the earth where the devil don't fit. No more bad times and no more wars. New Jerusalem, the city with the gold on the floors. Righteous laws, 1,000-year wars. The earth rejuvenated, Christ illuminated. I fight for the cause, kick down doors the devil set up. And I'm about to erupt, smack the warrior. I wear the armor of God, fix your face, raise the base, and stop looking so hard. You see, praising the Lord is easy for me. Craig Mack's right there, he's supposed to be. You're not close to me, you're supposed to be.